This is an ABC News special report. Now reporting, Chief Anchor George Stephanopoulos.
Good evening and welcome to our continuing coverage of a day unlike any other in American history. We were all brought up to believe it can't happen here, but today it did. You see the picture right there, a siege of the U.S. Capitol by rioters incited by President Trump, determined to disrupt the certification by Congress of the election President Trump lost. It all started to unfold around 2 p.m. at the Capitol as the debates began on objections raised by supporters of President Trump to the electoral count in several states, starting with the state of Arizona. That's the Capitol Rotunda right there. Where the protesters were let in, they started to roam freely through the United States Capitol. Members of Congress barricaded themselves inside the House floor. You see it right there as protesters tried to bang their way in. Agents with their arms, with their firearms drawn, were forced to hold back the protesters who broke down windows. There you see one protester who made it to the office of House Speaker Nancy Pelosi on the day where Joe Biden's win was going to be certified by the Congress. Other protesters carrying a Confederate flag right there. Others coming down the in the House hall to the ceremonial desk where Vice President Mike Pence usually sits. It went on for hours across the Capitol. Members of Congress were brought to safe locations. The leadership brought out. The response from the president, silence at first, after rallying with the supporters early in the day where he encouraged them to go to the Capitol. He finally told them to calm down, but also called them great patriots and perpetuated the lie that somehow this election was stolen from him. I'm here with our entire team tonight and David Muir, World News anchor David Muir. The words from President Trump on Twitter in that video, a stark contrast to the words from the president-elect Joe Biden.
Yeah, an extraordinary day, and it's hard really to process what it is we actually witnessed because we have never seen this before. And just as you point out, George, I think what we saw was this sort of split screen, this dichotomy between these two leaders in this country that we've been witnessing really for years now, particularly obviously in the campaign leading up to the election. But now in this all-important moment with just a few days left of this presidency, you talk about this one-minute video that came from President Trump. There was increasing pressure from Republicans and Democrats alike today that he had to come out and say something to tell them this had to stop, that he didn't support it, that he condemns it, that they have to go home. And instead, it was a one-minute video where he said, I know your pain, I know you're hurt. He repeated the false claim we had an election that was stolen from us. It was a landslide election. Obviously, as we continue to report, he lost the election to Joe Biden by 7 million votes. And what was most striking, George, is that he did not condemn what he saw in the Capitol today. He said, we love you, you're very special, it's time to go home. Shortly before that, we saw the president-elect Joe Biden come before the cameras. He called on President Trump to act, and he said, these are not protests, this is an insurrection, obviously was the word that he used. It made headlines immediately. He said he was saddened that America has come to such a dark moment. I call on President Trump to go on national TV. He said, today is a reminder that our democracy is fragile, but that we will endure. And the vice president, former vice president, president-elect Joe Biden, getting support not only from Democrats, but from Republicans. We saw that statement from former President George W. Bush, who used that same word, insurrection. And he said, Laura and I are watching the scenes of mayhem unfolding in disbelief, dismay. It's sickening, heartbreaking. This is how election results are disputed in a banana republic, not our democratic republic. A study in stark contrasts playing out today in the most horrific of ways.
Continues to play out today right now. A curfew has been put in place in Washington, D.C. The National Guard has been called in to the Capitol. The Capitol is secure now. In any moment, they're going to resume the debate on the certification. That is the scene in Washington, D.C.